We're going to hear from Western Kentucky All-American quarterback Bailey Zappe at the top of the hour. China Spring quarterback and up for Mr. Texas football, Major Bouton at 4:20. And then at 5 o'clock, Mac Rhodes, Baylor's director of athletics, will have off the radar, top five, and also much, much more. But kind of a different segment as we head into the Christmas week. We're in the Christmas week, but also into the Christmas break. Let's say that you want one night to do nothing and somebody else does something for you or perhaps cooks for you or caters for you, or you have a Christmas gathering and you're kind of like wanting something. Well, I got to know Shane Palacios again from the Cactus Rock Tamales. Went over and saw him. I played a round of golf one Saturday, drove down on Highway 6. He was there at Bar None. And in fact, T-Rex got to be there a little bit later on, and he joins us in studio, Shane Palacios, on Sikkim 365 Radio and 365 Sports. So when did this love begin, and how did you launch your business? And thanks for your time. Appreciate you being here in studio.
Well, first, thank y'all for inviting me. I definitely appreciate it. It started as a lot of things with my Wilita grandmother. My grandparents on my dad's side are from Mexico, so they brought the traditions, they brought the food that they knew how to make. Growing up as a little kid, I helped make tamales with her. What's funny is my dad, when he was young, did the exact same thing along with his siblings that were still in the house. So when I got older, you know, everyone bought tamales from other places and everything like that. But I was like, you know, I want to learn how to make it. And I couldn't remember everything. And I asked my dad, I was like, hey, Dad, how did Grandma used to make them? And he goes, well, this is how she did it. And he basically just taught me again what I just had forgotten. And then I started just doing it for family and friends and, you know, just people that I knew. And about 2-3 years ago, I was like, you know what? This is something that I could definitely try to do and start a business. And that's exactly what I did. And it's a process, but I've been very blessed so far.
Well, look, I do consider myself a bit of an expert on food, Shane. And I'll tell you, I mean, just look right here. That's that's all. That's my credentials. But these are fantastic. You clearly, you know, the differences in the meat. What, like, a lot of times you just go and, like, you have a choice. You have a pork tamale or a chicken tamale.
Right.
What made you decide to, like, look, let's go, like, this is birria, which is very good, and you have all the different kind of varieties.
Right. It's basically just wanting to stand out and be different. Because growing up, like you said, it was either pork or chicken. And, you know, I just didn't want to be like everybody else. So I decided to do brisket, and then I do portobello mushroom spinach with cheese and bean with cheese. But I have two different types of brisket. I do brisket and I do barbecue brisket that's been slow cooked in a pit. And I just do different varieties. I just want to stand out instead of just, oh, well, just two options. I want to have more than that.
Okay, I'm the one that you when I met you,
yes, sir,
and went down and bought some. In fact, gave some to Craig as well. It was birria, right? It was,
yes, sir.
That
was, it was the beef birria, yes, sir.
Okay, try to explain the difference between that, what that tastes like compared to brisket or anything else.
Well, the beef birria, what I use is chuck roast. So it's a higher texture of meat, and I slow cook it for about 5 hours. So, it's basically just cooked. I have my seasonings. In regards to brisket, everybody, you know, you live in Texas, you know what brisket tastes like. Not everybody knows how the birria, especially with mine, how it tastes. And so you definitely are able to tell a huge difference in between brisket and the chuck roast.
Yeah, that's true, because it's got that, like, really tender. Right. Not that, but like brisket's more of a fall apart meat, is where,
correct,
the birria is like maybe a little bit heartier, or like, you know, true. It's such a good flavor. And I'll tell you this, eating tamales my whole life, I've never had the cilantro, onion, and lime topper either, which kind of takes us over the top.
Yeah, but I mean, and that's another thing is we want to separate ourselves. Like, with the, you know, we want to provide that. We want to provide the chips, which they do come free with our salsa. So, I mean, we don't charge for certain things, and we want people to know that, that we appreciate that. Everybody who comes out to our events is a blessing, and we definitely appreciate everyone who has come and everyone who's going to be coming to our events.
So the roux, I meant the roux, the au jus or whatever you want to call it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Is it different types or is it pretty much the same one? The stock? How
do you, it's the same one. It's the broth that the chuck roast is cooked in.
And you just take that and pour it right back into it. Well, you have a little coffee container, kind of like one of those.
Oh, yes, sir. Yeah.
It's that to me is the extra key too as well. But yeah, you have cilantro, you have the onions, you have the lime. It's a full meal deal right here.
Of course.
How many of these do you, I mean, obviously depending on orders, but is there a specific, like on Wednesdays you cook 500 or what is it? How do you do that?
Well, it's a small business. It's just my wife and I. So, I mean, we have our regular jobs and everything, but it's something that obviously I want to do full time. So, you know, after we're done, we do have a building that we make everything in, and sometimes we decide to do 6-7 dozen an evening, and sometimes we decide, you know what, let's take the night off. And so it really just varies. Obviously, with this time of year, the amount that we make is in high demand. Because everybody just wants to have tamales for Christmas, and they still go for until after New Year's.
Yeah, that's a very Texas thing, tamales for Christmas. Yeah, that's very Texas.
Yes, sir.
And it's tender, and it's tasty, and there's different types. You have cheese, chicken, you have pork, you have birria, and you have...
the brisket. That's what I brought today,
the brisket
yes, sir.
As well. And then, by the way, Armstrong is just chewing away at his as well. You like him, Armstrong? You like him?
He's not even using a fork,
no,
man. He's
well, I'm not either. I'm
just going here, right
I'm
in.
Just like putting it in the sauce or the broth or whatever, and it's absolutely, you could almost just drink the broth.
Oh, yes, sir.
You could actually, like, almost like a cup of soup, the broth. So how do people get a hold of you? I know on Twitter, it's at Cactus Rock Tamal, without the ES.
We have the website. Our actual website is ilovetamales.com. Facebook, Cactus Rock Tamales, same thing as Instagram, Cactus Rock Tamales, and on Twitter, Cactus Rock Tamal.
You're telling me that nobody had ilovetamales.com.
That was just a blessing in disguise. The internet provider or the GoDaddy, whenever I've called for support, I have to give the website address. And every time I've called in for support, they're like, how did you get this? And I was like, I don't know. And everyone has always said, never let that website go.
No, ever. No.
And so one thing is I know that it has a reoccurring taking out of my bank, so I don't have to worry about forgetting it. so every year it takes out, and I'm happy with that. That is a very pleasant website because it's easy to remember.
Yeah, don't do what Jerry Jones did and DallasCowboys.com go.
Because I have a website. It's smokey.com. And every 6 months, I have that reminder to make sure that I renew whatever it is. And don't ever lose that. That would be awesome. All right. ilovetamales.com. Shane Palacios, he brought a ton of the tamales with us. Chicken, cheese, pork, birria, and also
brisket.
Brisket. Yes, sir. And it's fantastic. Tender, delicious, tasty. And we're going to sit there and make a fool of ourselves the rest of the show here on Sikkim 365 Radio. Thank you, man.
Thank you, sir.
ilovetamales.com and also on Twitter at Cactus Rock, T-A-M-A-L. You just don't have the E-S for tamales. Shane, thanks for your time again.
Thank you all, sir.
Coming up next.